Hello and welcome to Power Drift. Welcome to an all-new series called You Asked For It. And the reason why we're doing this is because there are search terms on YouTube which don't make a lot of sense, especially when we talk about comparos. But you asked for it. So here we are in episode 1, where we have the classic 350 on one end and the Dominar 400 on the other. Okay, to answer the question of why Q, we have a local expert who is an expert in sarcasm and motorcycles. Shumi, why?
No, I think the reason why the search terms are slightly weird is I think because in India, the number of keyboard racers and spec sheet experts is far larger than the number of motorcyclists. But I think there is a utility value to it because classic versus Dominar. Let me give you an example of a breakfast. Yeah. You have the choice of having cereal with milk. You have the choice of having ham, bacon, sandwich and eggs. They're both breakfast, they'll both fill your stomach, they both have different nutritional value. But with no stretch of the imagination, are these two interchangeable, right?
Nope. But what makes the Dominar a good motorcycle and where do you think it lacks?
I think the Dominar's biggest two things that people are attracted to is the spec sheet and the value for money that it represents as a 40 bhp 400cc motorcycle and all of that, right? But unfortunately, the Dominar's biggest weakness is that the spec sheet and the price doesn't really translate into that, let's say, that transformative an experience. Okay, because it's 40 bhp, yes, but it's also 193 kilos.
Yeah.
And you make that engine work so hard, the performance that it could have had based on the spec sheet doesn't really come into the real world. Because of the weight and because of the configuration that Bajaj has selected for this motorcycle, and this is something we've said before, it doesn't handle like a normal, natural-feeling motorcycle should. It's longer and it's heavier at the front and its slow steering is quite awkward and all those things. So when you put it together, what the spec sheet says will be amazing turns out to be okay. And I think what the biggest thing I would say is, if this is the fastest motorcycle you can afford and you think that that's why you're buying the Dominar, you're making a mistake. Because that's only one part of why you buy a motorcycle. The rest of the universe of motorcycling, the ride quality, the handling, the comfort, the feelings that you get from it, the memories that you intend to make with it, how it feels in the city. There are so many small factors in there. But you've basically signed off your money at value for money and spec sheet. I would not say don't buy the Dominar. I'd say think harder. This is a great starting point perhaps, but maybe your decision needs to do more research. But why should you look at the Classic 350 for that matter?
I think when Royal Enfield brought the Classic once again back to life, they had to stick to a few principles. One was the aesthetic bit, because the Classic 350 essentially is their bread and butter. So when you look at the aesthetic bit of it, unless you come real close to the motorcycle, from afar it looks exactly the same. And it's essentially a good thing for the brand. And for someone who's always looked at buying the Classic 350, for them, it's going to be a same looking motorcycle. But whatever you thought about the Classic 350 in the past, it's nothing like that. It is a lot more refined. It uses the same engine that you see on the Meteor 350, but it's in a different tune. I still feel the Meteor 350 has a more feel-wala engine. This feels a little subdued, but it suits the character of the Classic 350. So refinement levels are high, the ride quality has gotten a lot better. So in case if you were always thinking of buying the Classic 350, now is a good time to buy, because right now the Classic 350 in this form is a really good motorcycle to ride. Can this ride in the city? Of course it can. Can you go to Leh Ladakh? Of course you can. And at the price as well, it is not a huge bump over the outgoing model. So in that sense, I think this is a great motorcycle.
So what he's essentially saying is the Classic 350 is the way it is because you asked for it.
Yeah, and probably one of the reasons where why I feel, or one of the aspects where I feel it lacks, is just speed, performance. Yeah. I mean, you're expecting a 2021 motorcycle to be a little faster, especially for someone who's a little more experienced towards motorcycles. So in that sense, I think it lacks the performance bit, but that's the story of the Classic 350. Then let's focus on things a bit. Shumi is going to be the engine. What do you think about it?
So it's fairly obvious that the Dominar is the quicker motorcycle here. But the Dominar is not the easier motorcycle to ride. The throttle is heavy, so it always feels like you're working quite hard to make the motorcycle go fast. Whereas the Classic delivers whatever it's got, it's very, very easy, right? So the J-Series engine, I think the biggest asset it's got is, surprise, but it is the more refined motorcycle here. It's not the Dominar, it's the Royal Enfield. Yeah. Okay, that vibrates, and that's something Bajaj has still not attacked. Correct. The 250 doesn't, the 400 does.
Second, ride quality.
In terms of ride quality, the Dominar's format, that long and low format, has always caused issues. At the first upgrade, they softened the rear suspension and made it more acceptable. But I think the Royal Enfield's ride quality is just another level, yeah, because you don't expect it. But the way it does bad roads, good roads, speed breakers, the combination, the way they've tuned that chassis is amazing. I'm not going to say it's a sporty ride quality or a comfortable ride quality, but I think in terms of balance, that motorcycle is just incredible.
Government bik nahi gayi hai, ye sach hai, ye sach hai. And that, and with that, we'll move on to point three, which is handling.
Well, as I said, the long format of the Dominar really hurts it in the handling, okay? Because I keep going back to the same question, saying agar Bajaj ko tourer hi banana tha,
correct,
are to power cruiser kahan se mil gaya unko, right? Diavel power cruiser touring Europe, America, okay, India adventure tourer. This bike should have been an adventure tourer if touring was the intent at Bajaj from the start.
Yeah.
But now this bike is just way too long, right? So yeah, slow speed handling mein the front end is really heavy,
yeah,
and it's a long motorcycle, so you struggle a little bit. On straight lines, it's okay. Yeah. But if you are a fast rider like I've become, when you flick the motorcycle, the front end wants to wash first. Wow. So you have to give this motorcycle time. And strangely enough, the Royal Enfield, which can get away with being a slow handling motorcycle, is neutral. It doesn't react to being ridden hard or gently. It sort of says, yeah, whatever you want to do, we'll do. I have the capability to handle it. But I think you'll be more satisfied and confident on the Royal Enfield. And to me, satisfaction and confidence is why the spec sheet doesn't matter.
Absolutely.
The motorcycle needs to give you that.
Point number four, which is comfort.
Yeah, so the strangest thing about the comfort thing is that, first of all, let's understand comfort is personal.
Yeah.
It depends on your body style, it depends on how you sit on the motorcycle, how many hours you think is reasonable to spend on the saddle. If you're a new rider, you'll think 100 kilometers is enough. If you're an old experienced rider, you will say, no, I want one tankful to one tankful, which is 200-250 kilometers. So it's personal. But when Kartikeya Singhi went to Ladakh on the Classic 350 and came back, he was blown away by how well that motorcycle worked in that uncomfortable environment.
Correct.
Right? And from that perspective, I'm still going to say, pick the motorcycle that you think fits your body style better. But I have a feeling more body styles will fit on the Classic because it's a neutral, upright, naked style. Whereas this is a little bit longer and the handlebar is a little bit low. It's a little bit more specific than the Classic. But I don't think either of these are uncomfortable motorcycles on that front.
Yeah. Okay. So I think you've sort of spoken about the next question in a little bit, but we'll elaborate on that, which is touring capability.
Yeah. So my fundamental belief is that every motorcycle can tour. It's a matter of how long, and what plans you need to make based on what performance you're getting. And from that perspective, the Classic is a slower tourer and the Dominar is a faster tourer. But as a comfortable motorcycle goes, they will both cruise at roughly the same speed, which is about 90-110. The reason is that doesn't vibrate, so you're happy to raise the revs that high. The problem is this vibrates, so you won't raise the speed that high. So technically, the cruising ability will fall into the same zone roughly. In terms of space, now the Dominar with the luggage rack and stuff, it will carry more luggage more easily than the Royal Enfield. But people have been putting 2BHK houses on Royal Enfields and going to Ladakh forever. But to me, if you're thinking about touring in the country today, you need to have an ADV, because then you don't have to worry about what lies ahead. You load your luggage, you load your pillion if they are coming with you, and you go. No other format of motorcycles in India will do it as easily as an ADV, but everything will tour.
Yep.
You asked for it.
The final point I want to make is that the biggest difference between these two is flavor. It's not the spec sheet, it's not their speed, it's not the refinement, it's flavor. These are two completely different kinds of motorcycles. So if you're still in this dilemma, get off the internet.
Get off the internet, very important.
Get off the internet, stop watching this video, go to the Royal Enfield showroom, go to the Bajaj showroom, take a test ride, whether ham and bacon makes your heart sing or you want cereal and milk.
Absolutely. I mean, don't stop watching this video because we still have to end it.
Yeah.
That brings us to the end of episode one.
This is tough advice.
Yeah.
Because you asked for it.
You asked for it. And with that, episode one comes to an end. And I hope you enjoyed it.
Between these two, what would you write?
I think the Classic. It's without any thought. The Classic 350 makes a lot of sense. It might not, at least between the two, I think the flavor that I want to taste is something right behind me. I think I've enjoyed this more.
If I had the money to buy these two motorcycles and I had to pick between the two, you know what I'd get?
You'd get something else. I know.
Used Duke 390.
I knew this answer was coming.
To me, that is the most amazing touring motorcycle in the country, even including the adventure. Hmm. The speed, the performance, the feel, it remains sporty once the luggage is on. Hmm. And I don't ride with pillions.
Yeah.
How do you do it? And I don't ride with pillions. That's it, right?
Anyway, thank you so much for watching episode 1 of You Ask For It. I hope you enjoyed it. Of course, there are a lot of search terms on YouTube, which means we will be back, not just with motorcycles. I mean, we won't be back with cars, but Rohan and Cyrus will. If you have anything that you would want to see, then drop in your comments. Which one would you pick between the two? Drop in that comment as well. We will see you very, very soon.
Yeah, but I promise you, the Splendor versus Duel comparison is not coming.
Haan, matlab, kya comparison hai? Why? Don't ask for it.
You've seen the Royal Enfields with that big giant thing at the back. Yeah. I'm not even sure what they carry in there. It's like I have three girlfriends and they're in these three bags. I don't know.